Hai Nguyen is attempting to reach Ho Chi Minh City to have life-saving surgery, but he fears the treacherous roads have ruptured his tumor. Now 3 a.m., the ambulance urgently continues its mission. After 8 hours, they reach Ho Chi Minh City, home to over 7 million people. First, a private hospital runs tests to check the health of Hai's vital organs. The tumor hardly fits inside the scanner. Hai is dealt a new setback. The tests reveal he has a pleural effusion, an excessive amount of fluid coating his lungs, making it difficult to breathe. Hai is rushed to the oncology hospital to await Dr. McKinnon's arrival from Chicago. His tumor is so large, Hai is given a room that would normally house a dozen patients. Family and friends from Florida arrive to lend support. After a 30-hour journey from Chicago, Dr. McKinnon arrives in Vietnam. In the taxi, the talk quickly turns to Hai's pleural effusion.
Okay, so the effusion was bigger than 500?
Yes.
Why didn't you drain more? Why didn't you drain more?
The hospital fears it will affect the surgery, but Dr. McKinnon is confident it can be treated. At the hospital, news crews follow the doctor's every move. Conditions here are very different from what he is accustomed to in the West. In this state-run facility, patients are fed by their families, who often camp out in the halls while their relatives receive treatment.
Good morning.
Hey there.
We met before, but on the video, how's your breathing? I hear you've had some trouble with your breathing.
Mm-hmm. He said that he's better now.
Okay. You know, I think that this fluid is related to his position. So I wonder if it would not improve his situation to be more upright. Does that make sense?
Okay.
Breathe. Take some deep breaths.
The tumor seems to have grown since the pictures that I received many months ago, just to try and help Mr. Hai turn over in bed to examine him is a serious undertaking by itself. He needs two beds.
Okay.
Hai's pleural effusion has the hospital staff fearing he will not survive an operation. Dr. McKinnon recommends they remove more fluid and redo the breathing test. Over a pint is extracted.
Perhaps during his transfer, which was not so easy from his hometown, may have aggravated the return flow or backflow of this fluid into his pleural cavity.
We made a pulmonary function test, so it showed the patient is much better.
Yeah, Hai dễ thở hơn nhiều.
Despite Hai's improvement, the hospital makes a stunning decision. The surgery is canceled. Hai makes a desperate appeal.
I'm sorry, but you're right about that.
He really believes in you can save his life.
Well, it's not just about me. It's about the whole team. And I'm trying to convince his team that it can be done.
He still amazingly seems a positive man, although more desperate. I think he realizes that things are getting very serious about his condition.
Removing High's tumor will be a difficult procedure, but the bigger challenge is now convincing the hospital to try.
It seems that no decisions are taken by one person on an important patient like Mr. High. His importance has been augmented by press attention, I think, by the media, unfortunately.
Hi there.
To convince the staff that surgery can and must be done, Dr. McKinnon bans all cameras for a closed-door meeting.
Well, clearly, the patient is desperate. He made a very strong case for his own cause today. Well, I'm happy to argue with the experts. And I'm available to the committee. As I said in the beginning, I'm not here to be a tourist. Okay. Hi. Let's go see your brother. Without surgery, Mr. Hyde will die without a chance. Without a chance. I don't need to translate that, do I?